Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In my last video, I discussed a SMPS controller offline switcher IC TOP221-227. It is a complete family. One package that is three terminal device in 220 package. I discussed different parameters, and in DIP package, dual online package, that are these ICs, and I demonstrated how we can test it practically. And today we will see the function of this IC as well. It is the simplest, most SMPS controller IC that does not need any excessive components for programming or to set the frequency, because it is fixed frequency oscillator. To make its test circuit, if we are using TOP224Y, that is this three terminal device, I connected a capacitor, 47 microfarad capacitor, 35 volt, between pin 1, 2, 2 is source, this is drain, and this is control pin. When we will receive 4.7 volt to 5.7 volt, this IC works normally. Here I apply 12 volt to 14 volt 1 kilo ohm resistor, and I connected oscilloscope between these two points. Oscilloscope low probe here, high probe here. Let me connect it again, and same way we will test this DIP IC. I connected the circuit in the same way which we discussed in the last video. Positive voltage we will connect here, 1 kilo ohm resistor to drain pin, and drain pin is connected here to connect the signals. This is source pin, we will connect ground here, and here we will inject 5.5 volt positive voltage, ground supply to the source. For test purpose, I will connect oscilloscope low probe to positive supply and test signal from the source pin, and I will connect same way this multimeter UT202A common probe to the positive supply and high probe to the drain pin. Because this time I am testing the voltage, I am testing the signal across this load resistor, and then we will check between drain and source as well. First I will check here. I will take the same 12 volt to by this small variable voltage regulator circuit, and I will take the same 12 volt from this point positive and from the center pin, the supply point, to by this circuit. So I will take variable signal from this circuit. I will connect common to the common source pin, and this positive 5 volt signal I will adjust from this potentiometer through this LM317 TIC. We will connect to pin number 1, and we will measure the voltage at control pin, common from here and positive from here. This time 1.27 volt, no frequency. I am increasing the voltage when we have 5.3 volt, 5.4 volt. It is giving 100 kilohertz, and here is 100 kilohertz. That's good. This time we are testing the signal across this load resistance, and if I will connect the same low side of the multimeter here to the ground line and low side of the oscilloscope to the ground line. Okay, let me connect it here, oscilloscope common here and this multimeter common here to the source pin. The same way we will receive 100 kHz signal here and 100 kHz here. The difference between these two signals, when this MOSFET will switch, its internal MOSFET will switch at that time, it will give 0 volt. In the on state, when the MOSFET is on, we will see the low voltage on the oscilloscope. When it is on, it is allowing to flow the ground level to the load. So here we will receive inverted signal. Either we take common from here, if we will take common from the source pin, if we will connect common at source pin, we will check voltage drop across this MOSFET. And if we check here, positive high signal we will connect here always. We can take reference from here, so common here or common here, both the same way. Now we will connect this IC. I remove the power. Now I will connect TOP224 PN here on the project board. The left pin, that is ground, the left pin, that is pin number 1, left bottom pin number 1. Pin 2 to the ground, pin number 6, 7 and 8 ground. Now I connected pin number 1, 2, 3 to the ground pin. 6, 7, 8 I made jumper with ground. And I will connect this capacitor positive terminal to pin number 4 and ground terminal to pin number 3. 3 is ground, so we will connect positive voltage to pin number 4, that is the control pin. And we will connect this load resistor to pin number 5. And here we will connect the positive voltage at this point. And I will connect the drain pin here for connecting the signal. So this is our circuit. Here I will connect ground supply. Here control voltage 4.7 to 5.7 volt. And here I will connect positive voltage. Let's connect the supply voltage. The positive supply to the positive terminal. Ground supply to the ground terminal, the source pin. And I will take these voltage, the same voltage for my this supply card, but it will provide us variable voltage. I will connect ground, the output of this LM317 IC here to give variable voltage. We can use any voltage which we have. I connected to control pin. Now let's connect the multimeter here. If I will connect multimeter in the same way, low line to the positive terminal and high line to the drain pin, I will turn on this multimeter to measure the control voltage. I will connect common to the common pin. And I will measure the voltage from this point. That is our control pin. This time I have 1.2 volt. Let me connect the oscilloscope as well. The common of the oscilloscope to the positive supply terminal. And this is the signal. I connected positive supply at resistor 1 end here, and I connected common of the multimeter and common of the oscilloscope here, and I connected signal, high signal of the oscilloscope and high side of the multimeter at this point at the pin number 5, that is here. Pin number 1, that is control pin, and we have 5.7 volt. When the voltage will drop less than 4.7, the IC is off now. it will wait until the voltage level of this capacitor will regain at 5.7 volt again. Now it started again. It is called restart. At 5.7, it will restart again and it will maintain its voltage level until the voltage are between 4.7 to 5.7 volt. Above 5 volt until 5.7 volt, this IC will keep switching at 100 kHz. Here and here. Here it is showing 102 kHz and here it is giving 15 kHz. And if I will check with this multimeter, it is giving 101 kHz. So in this way we can verify the function of these ICs. It is basically three terminal device. Either it is 3 pin or 8 pin. It will remain the same. Control pin, it will receive 5.7 to 4.7 volt. So it will maintain its switching at 100 kHz. It is fixed frequency switching IC. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is informative, please hit the like button. If you have any question, kindly write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.